One, two, ready, go. Down in Oklahoma, figured out all three parts of that. A lot of people just do two. All right, this has been a long time favorite of ours on our family band. It's Apple Blossom. Okay, one, two, ready, go. Thank you. Great job. You can see why we like it. Thank you, thank you. All right. Well, we thought we'd slow it down and play one of our waltzes that we like to play at our reenactment dances. And it's called Shepherd's Wife Waltz. I've got to get it where it won't blow away on me. Can y'all hear my dulcimer? I don't think my mic is on. Okay, all right, all right. Right. Shepherd's Wife's Waltz. Okay. One, two, three, ready, go. Can just see them floating around with their hoop skirts around the floor with that song on our reenactment dances. And down where we are, we do Civil War reenactments. So, all right. I've been told by my banjo daughter that this is the wrong key for Colored Aristocracy. We're going to play it in D because we're mountain dulcimers. So. But this is a great old-timey song. It's called Colored Aristocracy. It was a cakewalk back in the during the Civil War times. They used it for a cakewalk. So you can, when you hear this, you can kind of picture that. So, all right. Oh. that was probably a more difficult song just because we're playing a lot on the middle string and a lot of us don't do that. So, to prove that we're experienced mountain dulcimer players, we're changing our tuning. We sound like a bunch of little bees up here. The teacher had to use the tuner, so sorry about that. This is a fun song, and somebody was asking about words. All we know, it's called Flop-Eared Mule. On the B part, we just know hee-haw, hee-haw. So if y'all want to sing with it, you can. The one thing about this one is, We play quite a bit up on the upper fretboard, which is hard because we're not used to playing much above the 7. And another thing is we played A part in G and the B part in D, so we have to kind of capo with our fingers. So it's a good practice for everybody, and everybody rose to the challenge on this one. So. Okay, Flop-Eared Mule. Are we all ready? Okay. One, two, ready, go. Introduce our rhythm section here. We have my daughter Angie from Texas, and this is her first time to be here in 19 years. She was here in the 90s, early 90s, mid 90s. And she and our other daughter will be up on stage in a minute. They came up from Texas. She came up from Oklahoma, but anyway, they came up to play with us and have a fun time. And I have Don Jordan and Scott, and they're on marimbulas. And if you're interested in a marimbula, Michael Allen in the vendor area I don't know if he's got any right now, but he does make he made these and he sells those, and they're great bases, great bases. So they've added quite a bit to our, you want one for Christmas, huh? Okay, last year I taught a song called Shoes and Stockings, we enjoyed that song so much that they all said, all the students said they want to play this on the program this year. And this will be our last song. We appreciate you listening to us and supporting us. We've had a fun time. The skill level of all of the Mount Dulcimer players are just growing exponentially as they get ready to practice for this. And so I'm very, very pleased with all of them, and I appreciate all that they do to get ready for this and encourage everybody. So, and Mike made our buttons. I want to make Mike Sanderson. Where's he? Right there. Made our buttons for us this year. Our pre-show buttons. We're pleased with that. Okay, we're going to do Shoes and Stockings. Oh yes, my daughter and my granddaughter designed them. Yes. Kara and Reese designed them for us. Shoes and Stockings, our last one, and then we'll say goodbye and thank y'all for coming. All right. One, ready, go.